Everyone, today we will have gynec lecture. Today we will discuss about the two terms, endometriosis and adenomyosis. These are the two gynecological disorders which are commonly seen in females. Especially these disorders are seen at the reproductive age or young age. There are many disorders which are related with menopause. Some disorders are related at reproductive age, some related with puberty and adolescence. So particularly this disorder is related at the reproductive age or seen in the young females. So endometriosis and adenomyosis. Endometriosis, that means it is the occurrence of ectopic endometrial tissue outside the normal uterine cavity, that we called as endometriosis. Ectopic, you know, it is the presence from the normal site or occurrence other than the normal site. So it is the ectopic endometrial tissue, that means deposition of endometrial tissue. Endometrium, it is the inner lining of the uterine cavity. So it is the implantation of this inner lining or uterine lining or uterine endometrium out of the uterine cavity. Normal location of endometrium is inner wall of uterus, that is the normal location. But if this endometrial tissue or endometrial wall is implanted out of the uterus, that is called as endometriosis. So definition is it is the presence of ectopic endometrial tissue outside the normal uterine cavity, that is endometriosis. Now causes for endometriosis, as in many disorders, exact cause for this disease or particular disorder is not known, but probable causes are, main thing is age factor, that is commonly seen at the age group of 30 to 40. Then it is related with hormone. Secondly, it is hormonal cause, that is estrogen. Increased level of estrogen is responsible for endometriosis. We had seen in fibroid also, growth of fibroid depends on the hormone estrogen. And this also, it is related with level of estrogen. Whenever there is increased or excessive level of estrogen, we can find this disorder. So first cause was age factor, reproductive age mainly, and secondly estrogen. Why reproductive age? Because in reproductive age only there is level of estrogen which is excessive, because it is related with pregnancy and other things. So usually there is increased level of estrogen hormone. So commonly seen at the reproductive age and depend on the level of estrogen. These are the main factors. Other factors are, as usual, it is related with family history, especially from her maternal side, then previous history of any gynec disorder. Next is hormone related pills or any steroids or any drugs, habit of hormones or drugs, or patient with infertility treatment, taking ovulation induction drugs for prolonged time. These are the causes. Nowadays there is dietic factors which are contributing for all these types of gynec disorders. So especially seen in obese patients with habit of junk food, fatty food, oily spicy food, all these things are contributing in the causes of endometriosis. And there are some other causes, that is implantation, that is Samson's implantation theory it is called as. Because in this theory, it was proved that there is abnormal implantation of this endometrium on the other sides or other nearby organs. That is called as implantation, abnormal implantation of endometrium, usually found on the surrounding organs. That is seen in the Samson's implantation theory. And usually this implantation takes place during menstruation. So this is the abnormal thing. During menstruation, there is shedding of endometrium, and this endometrium is implanted on the neighboring organs like cervix, vagina, fallopian tubes or other organs. And this is Samson's implantation, that is abnormal implantation of endometrium on the surrounding organs. Second is metastatic theory. In this theory, it was seen that there is abnormal metastasis of the endometrium layer. Especially it is seen from the embryonic life. There is abnormal metastasis of this endometrial tissues or cells. And because of abnormal metastasis, this is implanted or it is seen on the surrounding structures. that is metastasis theory. Next is metaplasia theory, that is the abnormal metaplasia or multiplication of this endometrium tissue or cells, and so we can see these endometrial tissues or cell on the surrounding organs. So these are the next is immunological theory. Because of altered immunity of some patients, it can be seen that there is implantation of endometrium on the abnormal locations. So these are some causes for endometriosis. First of all, it is age factor, reproductive age. Secondly, hormonal factor, increased level of estrogen. Next is family history, previous history, drugs of hormones or any ovulation induction drugs or any other drugs. These are the important causes. Some probable theories are Samson's implantation theory, that is abnormal implantation of endometrium during menstruation on the neighboring organs. Next is metaplasia theory, that is abnormal multiplication of this endometrial cells and it is deposited on the surrounding organs. Metastasis theory, that is also due to metastasis of endometrium tissues, it is seen on the surrounding organs. So these are the some causes for endometriosis. Because of either of this cause, there may be endometriosis or abnormal implantation of endometrium tissue on the surrounding organs. After that, there is pathology of this endometriosis. Etiology, we had seen the causes, and now pathology. In this, there is abnormal implantation of this endometrial tissue on the surrounding organs. Common sites for this endometriosis are out of uterus, surrounding organs are cervix, vagina, external genital organs, fallopian tubes, ovaries, uterine ligaments, round ligament, broad ligament. Other rare sites are bladder, urethra, rectum, intestinal coils. So these are the surrounding organs. So these are the sites for endometriosis. Among this, ovary is the common site where we can see the endometriosis commonly. So other sites are not that common, but ovary is the favorite site for endometriosis. So we see the endometriosis especially on the ovarian region. So in pathology, there is deposition of bluish or blackish or brownish cells or tissues as seen on the ovarian surface. Usually these are the small spots initially we can see. And this may be unilateral or bilateral. Unilateral means single ovary is involved. Whenever it is bilateral, both ovaries are involved. On the both ovaries, we see the deposition of endometrial tissues on the external surface of ovary. So it may be unilateral or bilateral. In initial stage, we see the brownish color or bluish color spots on the external surface. But these endometrial site can grow from millimeter to centimeter. So this is about the endometriosis external appearance. If it is grown from millimeter to centimeter, it can lead to cyst formation on ovary, and because of brownish color, we called it as chocolate cyst of ovary, because it is like a brown color, like a chocolate. So it is called as chocolate cyst of ovary. This chocolate cyst contains brown colored fluid, which is usually menstrual fluid. So this is chocolate cyst of ovary. It can grow from centimeter to large size or medium size. And as I said, it is unilateral or bilateral. So that is chocolate cyst of ovary. When it is mild, these are the small spots which are seen on the ovary. When it is moderate, it is from millimeter, but it is more than from mild side, but it is less than 2 centimeter. That means involving area or affected area is less than 2 centimeter, and when it is severe, that means size is more than 2 centimeter. So mild means spots, moderate means more than the spots but it is less than 2 centimeter, and whenever it is severe, that means it is more than that, growth is more than 2 centimeter, or that cyst size is more than 2 centimeter. So that is mild, moderate and severe gradation of endometriosis. So in pathology, in short, we had seen that it is the deposition of endometrial tissue on the ovarian surface, which is usually brown colored, and because of this color, brownish color, we call it as chocolate cyst of ovary. When this cyst is like a spot, it is mild degree. When it is more than the spot but it is less than 2 centimeter involving area, it is moderate, and when it is more than 2 centimeter growth, it is called as severe. And the cyst contains menstrual fluid or brownish colored fluid, unilateral or bilateral. So that is about pathology. Now, clinical features of endometriosis. As I said, it is the disorder which is seen usually at the reproductive age. So, patients are usually young females. They are complaining with irregular menstruation, or mainly it is painful menstruation. Because of this cyst formation or this endometriosis, there is painful menstruation. So there is dysmenorrhea, especially congestive dysmenorrhea. Because of congestion, there is congestive dysmenorrhea. All other menstrual disorders are irregular menstruation, excessive menstruation, sometimes amenorrhea, that is absence of menstruation. So basically all the menstrual disorders are seen with this. And because of this cyst formation, there is irregular ovulation. So second complaint will be infertility, that is failure of conception. Next complaint will be pain in abdomen, lower abdomen especially in iliac fossa, which site of ovary is involved. Depend on the location of this endometriosis, there will be pain either in right side or left side. If both ovaries are involved, bilateral pain can be seen. So lower abdominal pain is the discomfort, painful urination, constipation or diarrhea. It is related with bladder, urethra and other things. So complaints are associated with that. Rarely there is backache. Sometimes if infection, fever, chills can be seen. And usually their patient have, main complaints are menstrual related. So dysmenorrhea, menorrhagia, sometimes amenorrhea, and other things are backache, lower abdominal pain. Lower abdominal pain is quite seen because there is tenderness on the affected side. So pain in the iliac fossa, or especially at the lower abdomen. And other things, backache, lower abdominal pain with painful micturition, constipation, diarrhea, fever, chills can be seen. These are the main complaints from patient. Next will be signs on examination. General examination is usually normal because signs of anemia or signs of shock are not seen. This is a slow developing disorder or a chronic disease, so acute signs are not seen. General examination is normal. When we do the per abdomen examination, we can palpate the cyst. If it is moderate or large size, we can palpate that cyst. But if it is mild, we cannot palpate. But there is tenderness on palpation. There is lower abdominal tenderness. Depending on the affection of the ovary, either left or right, there is tenderness on the left iliac fossa or right iliac fossa. Both the ovaries are involved, there is tenderness on the both sides. So per abdomen, there is tenderness. If moderate or large size cyst, we can palpate that. PSPV examination, there is brownish or blackish spots can be seen on PS examination. And if there is a medium or a large size cyst, we can palpate the ovarian cyst on the posterior aspect. So uterine size is slightly enlarged. There is tenderness on examination, PSPV examination. So these are the main findings. Now investigation part is we do routine investigation. Along with routine investigation, we do ultrasonography. In ultrasonography, we can see this chocolate cyst of ovary. But for the confirmation, and nowadays we are doing laparoscopy as an investigative as well as curative purpose. So by doing laparoscopy, we investigate also, and if there is chocolate cyst which is very mild size or moderate size, we can remove that during that laparoscopy only. So investigations are routine investigations, USG, laparoscopy, and if necessary CT scan for ruling out any other thing like malignancy or anything. So we do the abdominal CT scan. But basically USG and laparoscopy is advised. And treatment is, as it is, first of all we had seen causes. In that, main cause was estrogen. So we have to give anti-estrogens, or we have to give estrogen along with progesterone. So basic choice of hormone is oral contraceptive pills, OC pills. They are recommended as they are easily available and cheap. We can prescribe the OC pills. So that can be given for 3 to 6 months. And the size of cyst or the endometriosis affection is seen on the USG. If it is reducing, we can continue the hormonal treatment. And if not, we have to change the hormonal treatment. And if it is not controlled or not reducing with OC pills, we will give anti-estrogen, that is danzol. It is an androgen hormone. So we can give this danzol hormone. This is also we had seen in fibroid. So we give this hormone for 3 to 6 months, and we see the reducing size of endometriosis. If it is reducing, we can continue. If not, we have to change the line of treatment. So basically hormone replacement, that is along with progesterone, we give OC pills, oral contraceptive pills. Either in the tablet form, we give injection progesterone also to reduce the level of estrogen. Medoxyprogesterone injections are given per week for some months. And if not reducing with this progesterone, oral contraceptive pills, we give hormone anti-estrogen or androgen hormone, Danazol. And if still it is not reducing with this hormonal treatment, if the cyst is large size, if it is ruptured or it is on the verge of rupture, so we have to do the surgical treatment, that is removal of this ovarian cyst. We do the cystectomy, that is removal of ovarian cyst. And in rare condition, we do hysterectomy. Otherwise, it is the endometrial tissue which is outside the uterine cavity. So we don't have to remove uterus. But in rare cases, if patient's age is more than 50 and other things are in favor of hysterectomy, we can advise the hysterectomy. But usually for endometriosis, hormonal treatment is preferred along with if large size cyst, we do the cystectomy, usually done by laparoscopic technique nowadays. Otherwise, it is abdominal surgery. So that was endometriosis. So endometriosis, just to summarize, endometriosis means it is the ectopic endometrial tissue which is found elsewhere from the uterine cavity from or other than the uterine cavity. So that is endometriosis. Causes are, it is because of estrogen hormone, especially seen at reproductive age, family history, hormonal history, dietary history, implantation of this endometrium during menstruation because of abnormal metastasis or metaplasia, or sometimes altered immunity. These are the causes for endometriosis. Pathologically, these endometrial spots are seen especially on the ovary. Common site is ovary. Other sites are ligaments, uterine ligaments, fallopian tubes, cervix, vagina, external genital organs. Other rare sites are rectum, bladder, urethra, intestines. Other things are seen. So common site is ovary. So endometrial tissues are seen on the ovarian surface. These are usually small spots initially. Then when it is mild, it is small spots. When it is moderate, it is more than the small spots, but it is less than the 2 cm area. And if it is large, it is more than 2 cm area, which is called as chocolate cyst of ovary, but because of brown colored and it contains menstrual fluid, so it is chocolate cyst. Usually unilateral, sometimes it is bilateral. Clinical features are, patient have menstrual disorders, all types of menstrual disorders along with dysmenorrhea, menorrhagia, metrorrhagia, amenorrhea. There is next is abdominal pain, lower abdominal pain. Next is backache. Next, urinary complaints, dysuria, painful urination, frequent urination, sometimes constipation, diarrhea. Backache is seen commonly because of endometriosis. And other things are, patient may have infective signs like fever, chills. These are the symptoms. Important is failure of conception, infertility, that is also seen. And on examination, general signs are normal. Poor abdomen tenderness, if cyst is palpable, if it is moderate or large size, we can palpate that cyst on the iliac fossa, or else there is a slight tenderness on the lower abdomen on palpation. PSPV examination, if the cyst is moderate to large size, we can palpate it at posterior fornix, or else uterine size is slightly increased and there is tenderness on examination. Sometimes we can see the spots, bluish or brownish spots on the genital organs. Investigative part is USG laparoscopy, and treatment is hormonal treatment. Estrogen, anti-estrogens are given in the form of oral contraceptive pills, OC pills, tablet form, or injection progesterones. And if not, we give androgens, Danazol hormone for some months. And if not treated with hormones, we prefer for surgery, laparoscopic cystectomy, that is removal of cyst. And in rare cases or in complicated cases, hysterectomy is advised. So that was endometriosis. Next term is adenomyosis. Adenomyosis means there is presence of endometrial tissue, but which is uterine, which is seen in the uterine cavity. there is excessive growth of endometrial tissue. So difference between endometriosis and adenomyosis is, in endometriosis there is presence of endometrial tissue outside the uterine cavity, but in adenomyosis there is excessive growth of endometrial tissue, which is seen in the uterine cavity, but there is excessive growth. So it is implanted on the uterus only, but there is abnormal growth of this endometrial tissue. So that is adenomyosis. Again, the causes are same, reproductive age and the hormonal things, estrogen-dependent disorder. Because of increased level of estrogen, there is increased level of endometrial cells multiplication. So that causes excessive growth of endometrial tissue. So again, it is estrogen-dependent. So main causes, age factor along with estrogen hormone increased level. So these are the causes, and pathologically we see the excessive growth of endometrial tissue, which is seen in the uterine cavity, but there is abnormal deposition of this endometrial tissue in the uterus. Because of this endometrial tissue or excessive growth of this endometrial tissue, there is blockage of uterine cavity. As we know, there is a normal menstrual cycle which takes place in the uterus, but if there is blockage or if there is excessive growth of this endometrial tissue, which is obstructing the uterine cavity, so naturally there are the disorders relating with menstruation. So clinical features are related with that. Patient will have severe menstrual pain, that is dysmenorrhea, congestive dysmenorrhea. Patient have backache, lower abdominal pain. Patient have painful urination, dysuria, frequent urination, constipation, diarrhea, rectal complaints, backache with this. And of course, infertility, because uterus is blocked or it is obstructed. So infertility, patient will complain failure of conception. So these are the main clinical features. On examination, general signs are usually normal. Sometimes we find shock signs if there is excessive pain and all. Otherwise, general findings are normal. For abdomen, there is enlargement of uterus. So we can palpate the uterus sometimes, but mainly there is tenderness on the uterine side. So patient have the severe tenderness. When we palpate the abdomen, there is tenderness. If it is large size, the adenomyosis growth is moderate to large size, we can palpate the growth for abdominally. PSPV examination, PS examination, sometimes there is bluish or blackish discoloration is seen. But usually for vaginal examination, we can palpate the increased size of uterus. And it is usually abnormally located, there is a slight degree of retroversion. I guess you remember the retroversion, that means bending backward of the uterus. So because of excessive level of this endometrial tissues, uterus is slightly backwardly retroverted, that is uterus is retroverted, slightly there is retroversion of uterus. So these are the upper vaginal findings. Investigations are same, we do the USG and laparoscopy. And treatment part is, we give the hormonal treatment. Depending on the amount of the endometrial tissue deposition, we decide the treatment, line of treatment. If it is mild, if their deposition is at the initial stage, we give the hormone OC pills, oral contraceptive pills for some months. We give injectable progesterone. And if the size is reducing, we can continue the hormonal treatment. But if the already the growth is obstructing the uterine cavity, patient have severe pains, patient have the menstrual disorders and lot of discomfort because of this growth, we prefer for the laparoscopic treatment, surgical removal of this endometrial tissues from the uterus. So usually it is done by the laparoscopic technique. And of course, if it is very serious and very complicating, we advise for hysterectomy. So that is endometriosis and adenomyosis. Difference between these two terms are, endometriosis means presence of endometrial tissue outside the uterine cavity, and adenomyosis means excessive growth of endometrial tissue within the uterine cavity. Clinical features are usually same, and age factor of patient is also same group is affected. All the things are common, so it may be misleading, but there is in endometriosis the tenderness, especially at the iliac fossa, and in adenomyosis tenderness is on lower abdominal side. We can palpate the cyst in endometriosis at posterior fornix, but in adenomyosis we palpate the uterus, increased size of uterus on the pervaginal examination. So these are the differentiating points, and of course we can differentiate by USG investigations, and we confirm the diagnosis. treatment is also more or less it is same. Hormonal replacement therapy is same for both. Oral contraceptive pills are given, injectable progesterones are given, androgens or danzol is given, and if not successful, we prefer for surgical treatment. So these are the two terms, endometriosis and adenomyosis.